High availability is the method of ensuring that your website or application is always up and running, so it's always available to customers.
Often refers to the amount of uptime that a customer would receive with a hosting provider. Typically, this may be in the region of 99.99% or with the likes of Hyve, 99.999%, which offers around about 5 minutes of downtime a year. As well as that, a lot of customers would factor in certain elements in the infrastructure. So if they'd incorporate perhaps an HA pair of firewalls, switches, where they're going to introduce load balancing, as well as obviously various software layer redundancy in terms of using SQL and always on and so on and so forth. High availability is quite important in the fact that we can obviously mitigate against any sort of downtime.
In some cases, for example, a medical institution or organisation, if they have data that they need all the time, high availability ensures that that data is available to the people that need it the most.
And essentially we're trying to avoid any single point of failure. So introducing stuff like load balancers, various pairs of firewalls and so on and so forth will eliminate that.
It's essential to running a business.
Essentially, it works in the fact that we're going to design a solution with pairs of devices, ideally when we're talking about network, or within the underlying infrastructure where we can cater for an unexpected downtime to ensure that we are offering a mission-critical service. And there's no solution that fits all, really. It all depends on customer requirements, but there are certain elements that we can introduce, such as replication, clustering when it comes to databases.
Or you can use different methods to actually achieve it. One of the methods is using load balancing. So load balancing, it actually splits the traffic between two different servers. So when a customer one comes down to a site, they go to server one, customer two goes down to server two. You can also use clustering. Clustering is when you have two instances of a database, for example, and the data can actually be brought from one or two of the databases. So if one goes down, data can still be taken or retrieved from the secondary database, which is, again, essential if you've got loads of transactions going through to one database. If that goes down, you need to have one other one that's straight away available to customers or for application systems. You can also use replication. Replication is a technique of transferring data from one, so it could be a file system or a database, and transferring it exactly across into another server or database. So if you had two databases, you want them to be exactly the same. So replication would mean transferring data from one live all the time to make sure the data is live on both.
And essentially avoiding any downtime where possible. Essentially all your data is not in one place.
So if one of your databases or file systems was to go down, if worse comes to worse, you can retrieve from a backup.
By having a backup strategy in place, we can obviously push backups to a separate SAN, for example, or even offsite to a separate data center, therefore ensuring your data is obviously not at risk within production. Should you want to discuss high availability and any other solutions that we may have in store, visit our website or give us a call.